have question number 61, which says that the solubility product of magnesium hydroxide is 3.2 into 10 raised to the power minus 11. So the pH of the saturated solution of magnesium hydroxide will be. So first of all, write down the equation of dissociation of magnesium hydroxide, which will dissociate like this, Mg2 plus and 2OH negative. Okay? So the solubility here is S and this is 2S. Fine. So I can write it the Ksp expression. This is S into 2S whole square as coefficient of OH minus is equal to 2. So Ksp ki value aapko diye, that is 3.2 into 10 raised to the power minus 11. So it is 4S cube. So from this you can calculate the value of S, which will be equal to 2 into 10 raised to the power minus 4. Now you have to calculate the pH of the saturated solution. So to calculate the pH, you should know the concentration of OH minus ions. So the concentration of OH minus is equal to 2S. So it is equal to 4 into 10 raised to the power minus 4. So calculate POH from this. So POH is minus log of 4 into 10 raised to the power minus 4. So apply the property of log. So it will be minus log 4 plus 4 log 10. ठीक है? So minus log 4 को हम कैसे लिख सकते हैं? This is minus log 2 to the power 2 and plus 4 log 10. So log 10 की value होती है 1. So it is 4 is equal to minus 2 log 2 plus 4. And the value of log 2 you should remember, that is 0.301. So it is minus 2 into 0.301 plus 4. So if we calculate this, your answer will come out to be 3.4. So most of the students mark the pH of the saturated solution as 3.4. But here this is POH. You should first calculate the pH. So pH will be equal to 14 minus POH. So don't make the silly mistakes in the examination. So it is 14 minus 3.4. So it is equal to 10.6. So option number 2 is the correct answer. So moving on to the next one now, we have question number 62. So it says that the correct order of covalent character among the following is. So covalent character we can decide on the basis of the Fajans rule. So higher the charge on the cation, higher will be the covalent character, and smaller the size of the cation, higher will be the covalent character. And here you have been given LiCl, BeCl2, BCl3 and CCl4. Okay? Here the anion is same, that is Cl. So you should consider the factor of only cation. So we have lithium plus, beryllium 2 plus, B3 plus and C4 plus. And also, the C4 plus has the smaller size. So, we can say that it has the highest covalent character. So, this is the order for covalent character. Fine. So, option number 3 will be the correct answer. So, moving on to the next one now. We have question number 63, which says that the entropy change for the conversion of 36 gram of water to vapor at 100 degrees Celsius is. Okay? So you have the equation, that is H2O liquid, which is converting into H2O vapor. Fine. And you have 36 gram of water, which means that you have 2 moles of water. ठीक है, तो आपको पता है कि एंट्रोपी चेंज क्या होता है, Q reversible by T. So here the process is for the evaporation. So we can write it like this, delta S is equal to delta H vaporization divided by T. ठीक है, तो delta H vaporization you have been given 40.63 kilojoule per mole. और यहाँ पे आपको कितने moles है? 2 moles. So multiplied by 2 divided by temperature. So temperature is 100 degree Celsius, so convert this into Kelvin, it is 373 Kelvin. Okay? So if you calculate this, your answer will come out to be 27.8 joule per Kelvin. So we have already multiplied 40.63 by 1000. So it is joules, not kilojoule per Kelvin. So option 1 is not correct, option 3 is correct. So we have option number 3 is the correct answer. Fine. So moving on to the next one now, we have question number 64, which says that the temperature at which the RMS velocity of O2 molecules is equal to the most probable velocity of SO2 molecules at T degree Celsius. So first of all, you should know the relation of RMS velocity and the most probable velocity. So URMS is equal to under root 3 RT by M. Okay? And U most probable is equal to 2 RT by M. Fine. So you have to equate the RMS velocity of O2 molecules to the most probable velocity of SO2 molecules. So I can write it like this. URMS for O2 is equal to most probable speed of SO2. Fine. So it is under root 3R. Suppose it is T1 that you have to calculate, divided by molar mass of O2, that is equal to 32, is equal to 2R. Temperature of SO2 you have been given T degree Celsius. So convert this into Kelvin, which will be equal to T plus 273 divided by molar mass of SO2, which is equal to 64. Fine. So taking the square root, we have 3T1 divided by 32 is equal to 2T plus 273 divided by 64. Fine. So this yahan se cancel ho jayega. So it will be T1 is equal to 1 by 3 T plus 273. So this will be your correct answer. So we have option number 1 as the correct one. So moving on to the next one now, we have question number 65, which says that the density of ice is less than water due to. So if you compare the structure of ice and the structure of water, both forms a hydrogen bonding. Fine. But in the case of ice, there is the stronger hydrogen bonding, as each water molecule is bonded to 4 other water molecules. So due to the higher extent of hydrogen bonding in ice, this has a open porous structure. So due to the open porous structure, what happens is that density of the ice decreases, and as a result, the ice can float on water. The first option, which says that the ion-dipole interaction in ice. So this is incorrect, because there is only hydrogen bonding which is present in the ice, not the ion-dipole interaction. So this is the incorrect option. Now we have the crystal structure of ice. This is also incorrect. Now we have open porous structure of ice. That is absolutely correct. And fourth is the different physical state. This is also incorrect. So option number 3 will be the correct answer. So moving on to the next one now,